Please listen carefully.
Well, hello, universe, and welcome to Optimist Daily Update. I'm Kristy Jansen.
And I'm Summers McKay.
And we're part of the team behind the Optimist Daily, making solutions the news. We bring you reader-funded solutions news every day in order to change the tenor of news media, social media, and the direction of your day to help make it one focused on solutions.
7 days a week, we publish positive news stories written by award-winning journalists and delivered online to your inbox and through our social channels. And also, we are sharing these solutions in commute-worthy, walk-worthy, home office-worthy, quickie on the 4th / 5th of July worthy podcast. Today is sort of Monday the 5th of July 2021.
Yes, sort of, because we, full disclosure, are recording this on Friday.
Yep.
To get it in the tank, so to speak, so that we can really enjoy a Monday off and the 5th of July, 4th of July celebration.
Yeah, we so rarely, I mean, anybody who is in publishing or news media knows that there are very rarely days that can be taken off. But our team has worked tirelessly for the first half of this year to create amazing, extraordinary, beautiful content. We are so inspired by their work. We are inspired by our freedom of press, our freedom of speech, the ability to participate in a world and in a community that is striving for liberty and justice for all. It is so important to us, and we just wanted to make sure everybody had the day off and could go celebrate their voice with their families. So we have a few quickie stories today, just because we didn't, you know, if you are listening to us on your holiday, because we're your favorite friends to hang out with, well, maybe not your favorite, but some friends, we didn't want to leave you hanging. So real quick today, Kristy, what are we going to hit?
Well, we're going to focus on a couple stories. One actually is from our Saturday feed. So you can look for the headline. You can probably Google the headline and get it, even if it's not on the homepage. Or maybe we'll put it in the trending. And then there's a couple of other funny ones. There's a study about drinking coffee, which may have benefits for your liver. I almost went for that one. But instead, I decided to highlight an article about exploring the great outdoors this summer without leaving a trace. You know, just a reminder that one, we have this amazing, beautiful nation, and actually everywhere around the world has beautiful open spaces. And camping is one of those great experiences. If you've got kids, it's so fun to go out and sleep outside or in a tent or under the stars or even just go on hikes. But it's also super important to think about our impact on those hiking trails or on those camping spots. And so this article highlights some tips about how to have a small footprint when you're on the trail. So I'll just read a few of these tips. First of all, don't feed the wildlife. It's super fun on the one hand, but on the other hand, like, bears get real comfortable coming up to people if they're always giving them food, and that can lead to not such great interactions going forward. Other kinds of animals also, if they get used to that, then they'll increase the chance of humans contracting diseases from the animals or being injured in interactions. All around a lose-lose situation. So just don't feed the wildlife.
Don't feed the bears.
And, you know, try to keep a safe distance away from all these really amazing critters and creatures and beautiful animals that share our open spaces with us. Thanks to innovation, we've got amazing technology like binoculars, which you can use, or you know, maybe some trail cams if you live on a property like my friend Megan.
I didn't tell you what we're going to do. Speaking of trail cams and wildlife, I just have to weigh in on this one. Because as you all know, we have this great big backyard that have amazing deer everywhere. We're going to put a deer feeder up, but we're going to put a camera. We're putting like a wildlife cam on it. So we're going to have a deer feed from the house.
It's that way, you know, you can observe them and hang out without disturbing or scaring those animals that are enjoying that. And you may get some other interesting critters out there too, Summers.
I'm so curious. It's like little wild pigs running across, but we'll see. I'm so excited for it.
Avoid cutting down trees for campfire wood. Bring your wood if you're camping or if you have to collect dead branches, but don't cut down trees. And so leave your tree felling tools at home and gather small diameter dead and fallen firewood instead if you're out there in the wild camping. And if you are, try to use established campsites where there's a durable surface like gravel, rock or snow or grass. so that you don't spread out and cause more water and pollutant runoff in soil and waterways. Be wildfire conscious, especially in areas with extreme drought like the Western United States. Campfires are really iffy, even in designated rings. So check out the fire restrictions before you head out on an adventure. And if you do build a campfire, make sure you're super careful with that and that it's fully, fully out before you abandon it. Try to leave no trace. That's how the saying goes. Only take pictures, leave only footsteps. If there's a designated trash bin, that's where you put all your trash, including toilet paper. Don't take souvenirs like rocks or shells. Everything has a purpose in the natural environment. And if you're hiking, stay on the trail. It seems exciting to go off the beaten path, but you damage vegetation and you might, you know, end up getting damaged yourself if you happen to like run into a whole bunch of poison oak or something.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Don't be a statistic, folks. Stay on the trail.
So anyway, that's it for the tips on how do you be a good steward of nature while you're enjoying it outside this summer. And what about you, Summers?
Well,
what are you gonna
speaking
about?
Of being a good steward of nature, for the more curated nature side of things, I have this ongoing debate with my husband on what we do with our lawn clippings. And well, we've actually got it settled by some brilliant writer research here at the Optimist Daily. I think he should just mow it and leave it exactly where it is. He thinks he should mow it, sweep it all up, and toss it. Well, it's actually somewhere in between. The headline reads, "Why You Should Leave Those Lawn Clippings Right Where They Are." Eco-conscious homeowners who live in really drought-present places who do not want to waste water are replacing their lawn with native plants and drought-resistant landscaping. For those of us who live with more abundant water from the air, with more rainfall, that might not be necessary, or you might not be ready to give up your lawn or grassy space. Mulching helps make this space as green as possible, both visually and environmentally. Mulching simply means redistributing your lawn clippings across your grass when you finish mowing, and that's where it's somewhere in between. You mow them up and then redistribute them out. You can purchase special mulching blades for your mower, but in most cases, just regular blades will do. Be sure not to mow your lawn when wet, and that's really important. Wet mulch can smother rather than nourish a lawn.
Which I guess is that your husband wins that battle too,
yep.
Right?
Yep, he does win that battle, which is like, it's. I love that the Optimist Daily update is also like a check-in on Summer's marriage, the ways of living in a conflict-free environment when you disagree on like a lot. But anyway, the average lawn does require 4 pounds of nitrogen a year for healthy growth. Mulching clippings provide at least 25% of this. I would hazard to say more. Worms, beneficial bacteria, and fungi eat away at the mulch. Yay, bugs and fungus. They boost the ecosystem diversity. It's going to be lower cost. You're not going to spend as much money on, you know, on the fertilizer, as well as effort and time on picking up all the clippings. You also don't have to pay for green waste service to take them away. And leaves, let's talk seasonally about leaves, mulch them away. Don't worry about raking them up. Just pull them in, mulch them, and send them right back out. Mulching is 100% beneficial for a lawn. So we pick up clippings simply because our neighbors do it, but it turns out leaving the mulch where it is the best thing you can do for a healthy lawn. So this is kind of a combination of how to increase the benefits of your green space. We have such a beautiful world, such a beautiful place to call home. And whether you are in the wild, in nature, hiking, on the trail, not feeding the animals, or you are mulching your lawn with a deer cam, be outside. We all know it's good for our mental health. We know it's good for who we are and who we want to be. I think that's it today, Kristy.
Yep.
I think we should just let everybody go celebrate.
Go celebrate your day off. And thanks, everybody, for listening to the Optimist Daily Update. We promise to keep sharing these kinds of positive solution-based stories with ideas on how you can participate in the changing world, ensure it is changed for the good, and we promise to keep covering current events with accuracy, legitimate sources, offering you information that you need and we all need to chart new paths for all of us. Thanks so much for everybody who signed up as an emissary last month. Thank you so much for all you guys. If you're not already, please consider becoming an emissary to help support us for just $5 a month. support reader-funded independent journalism on theoptimistdaily.com and be a part of the solution-changing consciousness that addresses our world's biggest challenges with that problem-solving mindset. Please help us keep the Optimist Daily free for everyone who needs it, which is everybody, supported by those of us who can. Thanks, everybody. We'll be back tomorrow and with regular schedule.
With regular programming, although we do have a special interview tomorrow, so stay tuned for that.
Oh, that's right.
It will be exciting.
Yes.
Great. Thank you, everybody. Take care.